worship you. We exalt thee because you are a good God. Thank you so much for your love, for your care, for your mercy. As your daughter said, many just died now. Many rushed to the hospital. Different things are happening that we don't even know. But here we are, your presence as Mary did. It's not because we are holy, it's not because we are pure, it's not because we pray more than the rest. It's your mercy, all your mercy, that made it possible. Lord, wherever we'll be disgracing your grace upon our life, wherever we'll be messing up the mercy, thinking we are whatever, have mercy upon me, have mercy upon us all, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And we have come to celebrate the victory that begot this mercy, the victory that begot, oh God, what we are today and who we are today. Lord, the victory is your suffering. The victory is your death. The victory is your resurrection. The victory is your ascension to heaven. And your victory is your being glorified. And here we are to glorify your glory. Take all that praise, speak to us, oh God, in the language we understand, to the end that we eat, drink you, and become like you, in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
We have a very brief exhortation of the truth of God, titled, Jesus Christ, the perfect sacrifice for our redemption. Jesus Christ, the perfect sacrifice for our redemption, for our freedom, for the solution you and I have for every situation, for every problem. Jesus Christ, the only power, the only grace you and I have to enter heaven on that day. For you and I to have a better resurrection after our suffering on earth here, after our husband apostling to his glory. The only grace, the only sacrifice that has been made for me and you to enter heaven is the one he has done already. No matter the sacrifice you and I will make, that is not the prerequisite of me and you entering God's kingdom. That's why before he left this world, he told us what to do in order for me and you to be keyed into that sacrifice he made for me and you. That's why he told you and I in John chapter 6, 53 to 58. Today Jesus said unto them, verily, verily, I say unto you. Anytime you hear verily, verily, please stop and ponder. Don't rush. It's a serious matter. It's a serious matter. Verily, verily, I say unto you, except ye eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, with all whatever you are doing, with all your professed holiness, with all my professed holiness and work, except we drink his blood, we have no life in us. Ye have no life in you. You that don't have life now, what now make you believe you have life again later? If you don't have life now, what now make you believe after death you have life again? So for you to have life then, have it now. And the only way to have it now is to eat him, the giver of life. 54. Whoso eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood hath eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. 53. 55. For my flesh is meat indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. 56. He that eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood dwelleth in me. In him, you will have that life he's talking about. Dwelleth in me, and I in him. 57. The living Father has sent me, and I live by the Father, so he that eateth me. He's so emphatic about eating and drinking him. He was so consistently saying it. Eat me, drink me, this is the solution. With all your holiness, with all your work, with all your whatever, eat me and drink me. That is the key for you to be what you desire to be. Even he shall live by me. 58. This is the bread which came down from heaven. Not as your father did eat manna and are dead. He that eateth this bread, which is our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, shall live forever. Can you see why the devil has no power over you? No matter the demon will send the hell to come and bring you to hell, they will never get you. Know why? When they come, what you'll see is Christ Jesus. Because he's living in you, you are living in him. Why? Because you eat him and drink him. And this was not done. This power, this right, this ordinance was not given just like that. It was given because of the sacrifice he made. He became the author and the finisher of our faith because of the sacrificial sacrifice he made. Brethren, John 1, 39 to 30 says something here. The next day, John seeth Jesus coming unto him and said, behold, the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world. Behold, the sacrificial Lamb of God. Behold, the only one that have been given to mankind for sacrifice, for propitiation of our sin, that can take that sin away. No other thing can take away sin. And if your sin remains in you, heaven is taken away from you. And hell is imperative. Hell is waiting for you. You must enter. Why? Your sin is not taken away. No creation can do this. No man of God, no apostle, no bishop can take away your sin. Why? Because no other man made the sacrifice but him alone. Verse 30. This is he of whom I said, after me cometh a man which is preferred before me. Christ is preferred before any other creation of God. Christ is preferred before any bishop, any apostle, any pastor. Christ is second to none. He is the first and the first forever. Why? He did what no one could do. He preferred before me, for he was before me. Though he is the creator, though in the beginning was he, and he was the God, and he was God, that nothing was created without him, yet he humbled himself and come and do what no man could do. He remained the first. Brethren, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the creator of heaven and earth, is the first and the last sacrifice. Somebody might ask me, but before he came to this world, was there no sacrifice? Before that time, before the world began, God has sacrificed him already. He only came to make it visible for me and your earth here. Nothing happened on earth here that have not happened there. Before Abraham was born, sacrifice was made through Christ already. Even before man's sin, the Lamb had been prepared already. Praise Master Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. That's why the Bible said in Romans chapter 12, verse 4, for Christ is the end of the law. Christ is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone that believeth. Christ is the end of sacrifice. Is the end of anything called remission power. He is the one that can remit your sin. No one else can do it. If anybody tell you, okay, you know what? Your sin is too much. Buy coconut, buy candle, buy oil, let me pour it upon you. Tell the person you're a witch. Just say it to the man of God, whatever, you are a witch. Why? It's only a witch that can be bold to say, let me kick against God. What do you want me to do? Okay, me stand together and you start to bath. That is witchcrafting. No other sacrifice can remit sin, can take away sin, can deliver you, but the blood of Jesus Christ. That's why I love that song. Nothing but the blood. That's why the Bible told me you in Acts chapter number 4, verse 12. Say, neither is there salvation in any other. In any other creation, in any other thing on earth, neither is there salvation, is there remission, is there deliverance in any other, for there is no other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Only the name Jesus Christ. Why? Because he gave the sacrifice that nobody could give. He humbled himself and became a sacrificial lamb for Emmanuel. And today, I can boldly say, I am delivered. Not because of you. If I put hope on the Christ of this mountain, hell would have been guaranteed for me. If I put hope on my co-pastors, my deliverance, hey, I would not prepare myself for hell already. So if anybody put hope on Apostle Emmanuel, hey, don't get prepared. Don't get prepared. You are lost already. Because no other name can give salvation. That's why the Bible told me in Philippians chapter 2, verse 10 and 11. For clarity, why this was done, read from 2, from verse 1 to 10. Say that. Okay, let me start from verse 9. Therefore, something happened. Get that one later. Therefore, God also had highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name. Then, that at the mention at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, sin bow, of things in heaven and things in earth, and this on the earth, and that every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord to the glory of God. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Why was this done? Because of what John said. Behold the Lamb of God, a humble self, to become a sacrifice for my redemption. Behold him. He did it. And today, he is the only one qualified in heaven, qualified on earth, and down the earth that can deliver. If maybe, for example, witches and wizards come to disturb the night, you shout Emmanuel, they will beat him up. They will shout my name. Hey, Apostle Emmanuel, they will flog him up. Know why? That is even rebellion. Somebody hearing me? That is even a rebellion act. For you to measure another person instead of Jesus Christ, you have just committed sacrilege. And the Lord will give the enemy even more charge to beat you. So please, don't call my name so that you won't allow this man to come and beat me in the house. So if you call my name, you might give them power to come and deal with me. So please, save me from the hands of the enemy. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As I said before, no other man, heaven, earth, and below, is capable, is qualified of giving freedom. I can give you money. I can't give you freedom. I can even maybe you are arrested, they're going to obey you. I can't give you freedom. I can pray for you, you are healed. I can't give you freedom. The only one that can give freedom is our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. No matter what you say, that sister today did, gave 500 euro, go through a journey of 10 hours. She was not the one that gave that freedom. Even as she was driving, if the Lord did not drive with her, go, she's finished. as she was giving that money, the Lord was not there. Like, she would breathe her last breath. You that came to console person, and it's good. Even the person will say, ah, what? What is this? The person you came to help will be carrying your body to mortuary. That's why we must be careful not to allocate the right of Christ to any man. Because he is the only qualified person that can deliver. 1 Peter chapter 1, 18 to 20. Say, for as much as you know, do you know that ye we are not redeemed with corruptible things? Man is a corruptible thing. This flesh is corrupt. Is corrupt. Except the Lord work on you, you are corrupt. As silver and gold, from your vain conversation, received by tradition from your fathers. 19. But with the precious blood of Jesus Christ, as of a lamb, which without blemish and without spot. See it? He is the only one that have the blood that is not blemished. So Lord, me and you, we are conceived by man meeting man. And we are conceived by a sinner, born into the world of sin. I tell you, our blood is divine, except the blood of Christ come and wash our blood. So if you try to use my blood as a sacrifice, you are adding more problems to your problem. If you try to use your children as sacrifice, you are adding more problem to your problem. Don't do it. If you are here, you are in all courts, you better leave there now before they finish your children for you. Hallelujah. Amen. Verse 20. Who verily was foreordained before the foundation of the world. Can you see it now? Before the foundation of the world, but was manifest in this last time for you. It had been ordained. It had been done before the foundation of this world. God knew that Adam and Eve were sin. Say God knows everything. And he have already make provision for our redemption. Praise the Lord. And when heaven sinned, you say, heaven sinned? Yes, they rebelled against God. For heaven to allow war to break up there, they have sinned. The blood of Jesus Christ was the one that also washed heaven. It was the blood of Christ that washed heaven. When there was war there, it was everywhere was scattered. The place that is supposed to be peaceful. The angels were not fighting heaven. God was angry. And it's the same blood that came that made Jesus, God was okay. Now, let there be Satan, you go to hell. Praise Master Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Verse 21. Who by him do believe in God that raised him up from the dead and gave him glory, that your faith and hope might be in God. He is the only access to God. You want to have hope in God? It's through him. Do you want to have faith in God? It's through him. No other source of redemption. I believe a word is enough for the wife. I want to stand up on your feet or kneel down or sit down. So I sit down comfortably and say, Father, I thank you. Thank you for what you have done for me. I give you praise, for you are the only one that have made me to be who I am. Celebrating, just think about yourself and thanking for that thing you have done for you. Open your mouth and celebrate the Lord. Amen.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my Father, Lord, I thank you, Daddy, for all that you have done, my Lord, my Father, Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, you have selfless sacrifice to save my soul, my Lord, my Father, Lord, I thank you, Lord, Jesus Christ. I worship you. I magnify your holy name because of whom you are, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, I do not merit it, my Lord, my Father. Daddy, Lord, Father.
In Jesus Christ's name, we have given thanks.
Amen.
First, we're going to ask him for mercy wherever we've ever attached anything to him. It's because of my strength. It's because of my money. I'm saved. I'm here because of Panadol. I'm here because of this. You attach something to what you have done. Say, Father, have mercy upon me. From now on, help me to glorify you alone in everything. In the name of Jesus Christ, open my mouth and pray. Amen. My money, I was able to do anything without mentor for me. Help me to be wise enough to always give you glory in everything. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus Christ, merciful name, we have prayed for mercy.
Amen.
Are you out there? You're not born again. You've heard the word now. His hands are still open. It's not yet closed. Rapture are not taking place now. He's still knocking at the door. Please surrender to him now, before it's eternally too late for you. Give him your life, confess it to him, and you become him. He will give you the life you desire to live and make heaven. If you have done that, please, I want you to call on the men of God for baptism. After that, you are now fully enrolled to start the race to God's kingdom, and nothing shall be able to stop me and you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Oh, thank you for the word we have heard. I ask, oh God, give us the grace to be the doer. Help those who are born again. And help everyone also go to run this race, oh God. Trust in you, depending on you at the end of time. In Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So please, let's set our table as the sister is not leader. Lead us in 1 minute. Worship, God bless you, my Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus, for the blood you shed for us. Thy blood saves us, Jesus. Your blood redeems us, oh God. Thy blood offers us salvation of our soul. We want to say thank you for the new life you gave to us, Jesus. We want to say thank you for everything, Lord, you have done. Jesus.
Jesus.
For the blood you shed for